You're doing, you're always getting a treat. So that's the decision tree. So the complexity doesn't really matter.
Hey, Ingo, I'm sorry to interrupt your important meeting with our chief furry officer, but it's time for...
5 minutes with Ingo?
5 minutes with Ingo.
Okay, great. Do you remember, Graham, we have been starting here talking about decision trees, but then actually we talked about Kenya's neighbors?
Oh, do you mean this episode?
You know what? Forget about decision trees. That's a stupid, boring topic anyway. We will talk about this another time.
Okay.
Yeah, that one. So, let's talk about decision trees today.
Sure.
We have a data set here about getting a dog. So people might make a decision, oh, no, do I pick this dog or not? And we collected this information. This is about the cuteness here. So we have a column here about cuteness. Cuteness might be low or high. We have the size of the dog, small or large. And then people decide, we just collect this information.
Yep.
So that's a table, pretty simple actually. And we would like to create a predictive model, a decision tree model, which we can then use for a new case, for a new combination of those values, to actually make this prediction, how are people going to react. And this is how such a decision tree could look like. Okay? So here you can see, we first pick the cuteness, and if the cuteness is high, of course people are getting the dog.
Aww.
Mm-hmm. And if the cuteness is low, they're also paying attention to the size, and if the dog is unfortunately large, poor dog. Well, it's not picked, so that's kind of. Anyway, so that is the result, and this is the data, so the big question is, how do we get from here to here?
Mm.
And the algorithm for building such a decision tree is actually quite simple. There's a formula in there, but it's not that simple, but the algorithm is super simple. It's what we call a recursive top-down strategy. So we start on the top of this tree, and we select the first attribute, the first column we use for making the split.
Okay.
And after we did this, we then take the different values for this column and we separate the data set into the two buckets here. So in all cases with cuteness equals to high, those actually are then certain cases, exactly those three rows here. And then there are three other rows which are going into this side here.
Okay.
Okay, so, and then if we figure out, well, it's not completely pure here, if we can make another split, we pick another attribute. In this case, it's simple because we only have one left. But even for more complex cases, you can use the same algorithm. And then we repeat this whole thing. So the big question is, how do we make this pick? How do we pick this first attribute at the root? So here is a different way to look at the same data. So let's have a look at cuteness. We can separate the data now in those two buckets, low and high. And here are the classes for those two buckets. So if the cuteness is low, we have one case with yes and two cases with no. But if the cuteness is high, all three cases are yes.
Sure.
And we can do the same thing for size. So Graham, looking at this data now, or this representation of the data, what attribute would you pick, actually, cuteness or size?
I would pick cuteness.
Why?
Because that is a clean list of data.
It is, right? Yeah.
Does that sound right?
Exactly. So this group here, those three cases here, it's really like it covers already 50% of the complete data, and it's what I would call like it's a pure bucket, like it's only yes cases. And that's really something we would like to achieve. We would like to end up with the very pure cases here. So that is good. And even in this case, two-thirds are no cases, so we have a clear separation. While here, the pure bucket is smaller, and here it's just 50-50, so it's less clean.
Sure.
And there's actually a formula for this.
How convenient.
Call this the I just brought this piece of paper here. So we call this the information gain, and we use something called entropy for calculating the information gain by just using the weighted sum of the entropies for those two cases. So here the split is 1/3 versus 2/3, and here it's basically a pure play. And whenever the entropy it's pure, the entropy is actually zero. So that's good. So we end up with an information for the split of 0.14, and for size it's 0.2, And then we can actually compare this to the entropy before we did the split, which is another value, and then we can calculate the information gain, and you can see, if you subtract this here, that the information gain for cuteness is higher, 0.13, than for size, 0.07. That's why we pick cuteness at the root of this tree.
Got it.
So that's the basic algorithm. Very, very simple. It's a good heuristic, leading to a good predictive model, and that's, well, on decision trees from my side.
Fantastic. Thanks, Ingo. And this has been your 5 minutes with Ingo and Marla. And you'll comprehend this doggy thing. Said in the end, you'll comprehend this doggy thing. Said in the end, you'll comprehend it's a doggy thing. Said in the end,